Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the previous part we finished off the boss monster for this level. In the meantime I've also killed most of the outside monsters. There's still a couple running around but they're not too important, so I think it's about time to move up to level 8. Now to do that, normally you would go down this tunnel filled with locked doors, which would cost us a ton of keys, but thankfully there's an easier way to get there, or at least a less expensive one. As you can see, these doors lead up to here, but yeah, we can actually do it without wasting so many keys. And the way to do it is first of all to get to the top of the level, as you can see here, and then move all the way to the left. The reason I keep jumping up at every intersection is because the teleports are mostly situated between these ladders, so if you just move diagonally upwards past these crossroad points, you can actually avoid the teleports. So once we're here, as you can see, we're now on the other side of this wall, which separates us from this tunnel filled with doors, and the way to get past them is to go down here. You know what, I'm going to ignore this growl for the moment because it's a little bit strong and it doesn't have anything of value for us. And then we go diagonally down past this door into this tunnel. Now once you're in this tunnel, you will have to move to the left here. Fire Drake, oh well, might as well shoot him. Then go down here, then to the right, then down here and to the... oh no, down again and then to the left. Then down this hallway, down this one, again to the left and down this one, and we end up right here, right between the ladders that lead to the two separate portals. Now if you remember, the right one is the one we came out of, which of course then leads back to the previous level, and the one on the left will contain the portal to the next level, level 8. So let us take the portal further down. There's no real reason to go back up anymore. I might not even actually go back to the king at this point. And enter the tunnel to level 8. Now as you can see, level 8 is quite a bit different from the levels we've seen previously. There's a lot of open space. There's mostly these ladders which connect the different platforms, which contain the shops and the towers and all the other stuff we're looking for. I think I might actually pick up some more food. We still have plenty, but we have a ton of gold, so let's not be stingy. You know what, let's get 5,000 worth. Get us back up to almost 200,000 food, that should last us for quite some time. Okay, so this level, as you can see, it looks a little bit chaotic, all these weird weird floating platforms connected by these ladders. It's a little bit confusing. And they are completely interspersed with these monsters, which are, I would say, extremely dangerous to us for the moment. Spine devils are kind of the exception. These are the only kind of weak ones we will meet in level 8. Everything else is pretty dangerous to us right now. So we have to be a little bit careful. Thankfully, these spine demons give us some keys and some pendants and other stuff. Now, like I was saying, these levels look a little bit chaotic, and it looks a bit like, there's no real rhyme or reason to them, but if you look at the complete field map, you can actually see that these blue stones are made in the shape of the planet Earth. So this is actually one of the areas where you can see it most clearly. This is Africa I'm sitting in right now. You can see the east coast of Africa right here, the west coast of Africa on this side. Oops, I probably needn't have opened that, but that's okay. And if you go down here, you can see it ends up in the point of South Africa here. So it's actually pretty funny. I never knew this back in the day, but now that I have complete maps, you can actually see that, there's a little bit of a design going on here. And to that effect, there are also two towers in this level. And one of them is actually located in the center of America, and one of them is located more or less in the center of Asia. There's actually a third one as well, located all the way up top, but that one is not really worthwhile, so I won't go too far into that. So yeah, without further ado, let's have a look at where the towers are. There's a lot of dead ends, as you can see. But this is actually the American Tower. It's located sort of halfway between North and South America, which also contains, up here in Alaska, the gateway to level 9. I'll show you that one briefly as well. As you can see, up here, completely protected, so the only way to get to this is to open all these doors, is the entrance to level 9. We could already go up there, technically, but there's a couple of items I want to loot from level 8 first. From this point on, I'm not going to worry about killing every single monster in the level. I might come back and kill them later if it's completely necessary, if we need one or two more levels to get to the end boss. But I have a feeling we have pretty much the levels we need already, because we've been very good about clearing out the earlier levels. Okay, so, like I was saying, this is the American Tower. This one holds a couple of items we need. And the Asian Tower is on the other side, which I will try and get to now. I'll just go across the bottom, that's easier. Man, these monsters won't leave me alone. A couple of these monsters we do want to kill, because they have interesting items. The flying ones you saw just now, I think they're wyverns. I can give you an elixir. Ah, here we go, this is the Asian one. And there's a couple of others that have good items, like hourglasses and stuff, so we might kill off a couple of them, but most of them I'll probably be ignoring from here on. So yeah, I think that gives you a pretty good idea of what level 8 is like. Confusing and chaotic. Oh, you know what? Actually, that's nonsense. This is the American one as well. I just went all the way around the map. I didn't go to the right place at all. The Asian one is on this side, I think behind this wall somewhere. No. Oh, it's up here, yeah, now I remember. Next to the weapons store. This is it, this is the one I was looking for. So yeah, most of the good items are in either this tower or the other one I just showed you. There's one more, which is all the way up top, which I think we can see from up here somewhere. No, other side. Yeah, this is it. Yep, up here. You might have seen the door flash through the screen on the top right just now. I'll try and get it in again. There you go. So up here, if you use the flying boots, you can actually fly up to that tower. And yeah. Personally, I don't think it's really worth it, because it eats up a wing boot, which is very valuable. And the only reward you get is a couple of bottles, and at the end there's an elixir. And since we already have quite a few elixirs, and we'll pick up a couple more from these red guys that you see flying around here, the wyverns, I don't really see the point of wasting a boot and a lot of time going through that tower. So there's basically two towers we want to clear out in this level, and both of them are pretty easy, I'd say. They're not the hardest towers in the game. So yeah, we'll get to that in a moment. First, let me get rid of these spined devils. Yep. And we will move on to the towers. I think I'll start with... actually, you know what? It doesn't really matter what we start with. I'll start with the closest one, the Asian one, right one, this one. Just saving the game quickly. So yeah, that's pretty much level 8 in a nutshell. I will start taking on this tower, but I think I'll save it for the next part. I'm not sure how much time I have left. So I cut off the video here. Thanks for watching, guys, and in the next part we will be clearing out the level 8 towers. See you then.